Technically, prime sight is not directed at me, so awareness wouldn't apply for me.
The scene is set for Living World of Darkness, New York. Chad and Operator 5 are, they're using a, just meet up, watch a few movies as an excuse to double check one of Operator 5's friends, make sure he hasn't been possessed by an Nephandi filter, to put it bluntly. So before they go up and pick him up, they're driving the street to pick a point where he's supposed to be. This, they've obviously rung him, so he'd be at the street corner, and they'd be able to get a good scan on him, make sure everything's okay. But they're driving up in a different vehicle first. They pull over. Maybe the guy inside's taking a phone call. Maybe, whatever. Who knows? But it's got blacked out windows, and Chad will sit there patiently in the passenger seat and let Operator 5, do his thing.
Hold on. Is that him, the street corner?
I don't know. He's your friend.
Kyle's just sitting there playing on his smartphone.
Hold on. Need to get more sleep. So he's going to pull out his scanner, aim it in Kyle's general direction, and ping a scan once. I go, all right, yeah, okay, that's not bad. I'm gonna double check with a visual. Okay. That's weird. He's gonna adjust the readouts on the scanner and check to make sure he's not possessed by some horrible demonic alien. Okay. All right, yeah, he's not being ridden by any extra-dimensional entities.
What's up?
He just looks weird. Without a character, my character doesn't have any lores that would help him at this point.
Will not help. There are no lores.
That's my point. That's my point. That is my point. The void engineer is completely in the unknown. It's just like, okay. This is, his biofield looks a little weird.
Okay, how about we,
He's gonna pass. Yeah, he's going to pocket the scanner again.
He's never given you trouble before, though, right?
No. Okay. Remember I told you I was going to outsource the chassis and the casing for the energy cannon?
We ordered the food. I could keep a hold of some samples, saliva or whatever, we can get our hands on. We could maybe run some tests, figure out what's going on. Which will lead us nowhere.
It'll just make
Operator 5 will get that look on his face. Yeah, maybe Cynthia could run some sort of scan, but she's... I'm going to have Tony sit on his house for a while just in case that Hoyt guy shows up.
Maybe,
He's got a...
You said there was that guy who shows up at the ice cream parlor. Maybe he did something? No, because...
I know.
Nephandi, everyone's going to tell us those things.
Yeah, no, Jericho... He's just going to look at Chad and go, when I mouthed the word Nephandi at Jericho, I didn't say it. His reaction was to quickly walk away and ride off in utter terror. I don't think he would have screwed with anyone. Doesn't strike me as the malicious sort.
Okay, so if it's not him, it's not Hoyt. Could have been somebody else that was there or you encountered since, or have you done previous scans?
Yeah. Yeah, he's just a normal guy. He runs the makerspace. Like I said, I outsourced the chassis and frame for the energy projector to his shop.
Okay, well, continue or abort? That's the question.
Yeah, whatever. We'll bring him home for dinner. He's a good guy. But yeah, you'll like him.
Yeah, and they'll drive around. The van will take off. They'll drive around about a block later. They'll get out in the parking lot. They'll switch over to the other car. And actually drive up, and this time let Kyle come in.
And, you know, Kyle kind of, you know, looks up again. He's like, I assume this one does not have tinted windows.
No, I don't think so.
Yes, so he looks up, says, oh! You know, waves, pauses, and heads on over.
Once he gets in, Chad will put his hand behind him to shake the man's hand in the back. Chad?
Kyle.
Yeah, Chad. Kyle, Chad.
Yeah. Oh, so movie night.
Yeah.
What's on the what movies?
Got a few. We've got Netflix and things like that as well. Awesome. I'm gonna order some food. Thinking pizza. Somebody objects.
That works. Yeah, so, just as long as it's not too spicy, we're good.
You just hand back a pen and a notepad. Just write down whatever you want.
Chad and I, we've worked together a few times. I've done some projects before.
Is he also a maker, or?
No, he's
legally's side.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he was the company's PR man when I was doing my internship.
Ah, cool.
Before I opened up the shop.
No, I managed to befriend someone back as an undergrad before I went to get my doctorate. He ended up in law school. I ended up there. So, and now the guy handles most of my patent and contract work. Candy,
if you need a hand looking over something quickly or some advice for men's out touch, let me know.
Will do.
Chad.
Yep.
Chad, actually, the first time I actually saw Chad work, he had this, like, mountain of paperwork all over his desk. And they just kept adding to it. We went to lunch. We come back. And he's sitting there with, like, was it a can of ravioli? And people were screaming because they didn't expect to have the paperwork done that fast. He threw everybody's schedule off for a week. It was great.
Chad will turn around, give a good smile. It's like, yeah, I'm a bit of a freak. I like doing budgets.
I can at least, you know, do a bit of mine and occasionally a little bit of speculative work, but mostly what I've got is a good head for what needs to be done.
What are you working on at the moment, if you don't mind me asking?
I just finished up the filters for Dubai. Well, basically they wanted something that would allow them to more quickly refine crude oil. And so, you know, I was able to provide that. What's next? Actually, I'm on a bit of space between projects right now. Which, you know, means that I probably would have had time to play the WoW expansion if I still played WoW, and if it hadn't been DDoSed to hell for most of the time.
Yeah, that's just bad PR.
Well, you know, What, the getting DDoSed?
Just how they're handling everything. After Diablo, they should have been ready for this kind of stuff. I get more came back than they expected, but still.
Well, that's the thing. That's been the case every other thing. They've always gotten more coming back than they expected. But this time, they did not expect someone to actively DDoS their servers. So.
Don't they pay people to expect that kind of thing? I mean.
When it comes down to it, it doesn't matter how. Unless you pretty much are going to take over an entire trunk, it is entirely possible to have someone who brings in a DDoS better than your hardware can handle.
Yeah, programming is the mind of the business. It's kind of drugs.
Yeah.
Although I'm having to learn.
Well, it's honestly a bit more networking than actual programming, but... But yeah. I was looking forward to maybe playing Unity, but then that thing had all sorts of issues. So now I'm just like, now the game I'm looking forward to is fucking Dragon Age. After Dragon Age 2, I said, well, you know what? Fuck you, EA. And then this comes out, and like.
Yeah, I got a copy of 2 when I was stationed out in the middle of nowhere. I didn't enjoy it at all. It was so in a bad month, and it was a horrible, horrible letdown.
Yep. I mean, Origins wasn't amazing, but it was okay. And it was something that we hadn't really gotten, so, you know, that was nice. But 2 was just a pile of crap.
Yeah.
But what's funny is the one complaint I heard about Inquisition is all the characters are ugly. I'm like, and?
I don't care about a lot of my games from the. Yeah, I still prefer a lot of the old RPGs from the Super NES. I'm weird, apparently. I like sprite graphics.
Two of the best Square Enix games, or actually they were just Square back then, two of the best Squaresoft games came out of the NES era. You know, Final Fantasy VI and Chrono Trigger.
After a little bit, they'll all, you know, arrive, walk into the garage, and go up the elevator. The apartment's quite large. You'll see some furniture. There's 2 couches. There's 2 couches. It's very, in some ways, it's kind of Spartan. It's very tidy. There is a, there's a large flat screen TV. But as well as that, you can see there's 1 or 2 games consoles, like there is a PlayStation 4 and an Xbox One. You can see there's a couple of older ones. There's like a PlayStation 2 there, but if you're trolling any of them eye towards them, you can see the PlayStation 2 seems to be getting a lot more use than the other ones, for whatever reason. But before too long, the food will be delivered, and then we'll get there, whatever they ordered, laid out.
Well, so, what do you guys want to watch?
Since, sorry,
Well, you said you know, since this is theoretically movie night.
Oh yeah. He starts going through a few different DVDs. We have some classics.
Well, Chad.
What?
Yeah, well, Chad's actually going through the DVDs. Op is gonna look over at Kyle and go, "Yeah, that Hoyt guy the other night."
Oh yeah, he's something's off about him.
Yeah, got that vibe. Be entirely honest, after I talked with him, I went back out to the truck and got my sidearm.
Right. It seemed there's one thing that really seemed off about him is he seemed like someone who wasn't used to his own skin, if you get my meaning.
Yeah, that's one way to put it.
Yeah, over Kyle's shoulder. Chad will look at Operator 5 and be like, what the fuck? But he'll quickly go back to calling out different movie names and, you know, going to maybe file stuff. Could, I don't know if you can do something off about the guy. I could put in some paperwork, check the public record, that kind of stuff. They like their bureaucracy.
Well,
I like the challenge.
Was in the army, I think he said.
Yeah, he said he was a veteran. Honestly, probably whatever else you find, you'll find that is that as far as paperwork goes, he's probably going to be on the up and up until fairly recently.
This time, Operator 5's going to look at Chad over Kyle's shoulder with the what-the-fuck look.
Yeah, just kind of like, why would you say that?
Stupid flaw.
Bad at lying.
No, I'm actually honest to a fault.
It's good because I've got confidence that increases the difficulty of your lies by two. To me.
And this is why when I buy my fourth thought of appearance, I'm not going to feel guilty about getting appearance specialization adorable.
Ghostbusters?
Yeah.
And someone asks you if you're a god, say yes.
So what you...
There's situations where you don't want
to... I'm sure there are, but, you know, it's a good line.
Yeah,
Chad's gonna, when Kyle's back is turned, he's gonna send off a quick test message to Operator 5. Like, he'll start setting the things up then. Put on some popcorn, a few plates and stuff. People need them. Is he going to sit down?
And probably around this point. A quick question. To activate an edge, do I have to spend...
Not unless it says. What edge are you going to using?
Discern.
That's your perception plus seal, difficulty 6. You can gamble if you so wish, but you don't have to. You don't have to spend any.
Gambling allows me, I get extra dice.
You get extra dice, and if you succeed, you'll get an additional conviction point.
All right. Yeah, I will gamble too.
As long as there's some kind of meaning.
Hold on. Before you actually make that roll, Operator 5 is wearing his earpiece, is Chad.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
We needed to clarify that before we made the roll.
Nope. Well, I think it's safe to say I gained an expectation off that.
Yeah, so you're just going to notice, just picking up the data, there's just something a little bit off about us, just how we react to environment. It's just ever so slightly off. You would probably almost never have noticed it without discern. And then, as you're kind of looking at us, you probably see first in one of our ears, and then we look to yours, the other ones, as the evening stretches on. You'll notice you've got, well, you can describe them.
There's sparklies around our heads.
They don't sparkle, it's not second sight. But you will notice basically very small, discreet earbuds. But they just seem, it seems a little bit strange given the circumstances that we've had them in.
Yep.
God knows those things are not coming out, especially after we read you being weird to some degree. So yeah, no, they're not human, but you don't know what the fuck they are.
Yeah.
At any point during the movie, is Operator 5 going to check his phone?
Yeah, probably when the song starts up, when they're running out of the library.
When he checks his phone, there's a text from Chad saying, "Is he fucking with us?"
Yeah. Is Kyle going to get up and use the bathroom at any point during the movie?
Oh, probably.
Yeah, well, once he's in the bathroom, Operator 5's going to look over to Chad and say, "Probably not."
Okay.
Yeah, did you want to search the bathroom, Kyle?
I'll probably at least, like, you know, do the very basic, the very common thing of look through the medicine cabinet behind the, you know, assuming you have one.
You look in there. There's toothpaste, some unopened toothpaste, some spare toothbrushes. There's dental floss. There's some, you know, paracetamol, like razors and stuff. That's it. There's some bits of, like, you know, it's like as you look around the thing, there's a bit of like nice handy kind of gadgets things. There's a propensity towards that, but yeah, no, there's nothing that's going to come up under discern. Nothing that's coming up is absolutely. It's just that is the one thing you will notice is there's a bit more techie stuff, but this is all. I'm not going to ask you to roll.
Is there a soap dispenser on the wall?
There is a soap dispenser on the wall. It's all a, you know, over the counter stuff, but it's just there's a lot. There's more of it than normal. You know, maybe that's something he's into, or I don't know.
Yep. And yeah.
Actually, give me a perception alertness roll.
Let's see. Is that four dice again? That is four dice again. Roll. No.
You do not notice that.
Yep. So, you know, come back out. And, you know, idly say, so have you ever considered picking up a water pick?
Haven't thought about it too much. But
I got one, and it's, let me put it this way, it's much more, makes flossing a lot less of a chore.
Well, no, I'll consider it. Could be useful.
And, you know, he looks around. It's only $50, so it's not like it's going to put you back that much.
True. Yeah. Is there anything anybody else wants to get up to throughout the evening? Because Rome's not going to sit through role playing and watching like an hour and a half long movie.
Eating and making the obvious jokes at the obvious film.
Yep. And you'll definitely notice that Kyle tends to make jokes that are a bit on the gallows side.
Actually, when it gets to the point where the Marshmallow Man explodes, would you like an empathy check?
Sure. Let's see, I think I've got 5 dice for that one. Oh, nope.
Okay, you will not get the emotional read other than he just, Operator 5 just kind of winces. But they're covered in the goo. Chad will remember why.
So the evening will wind up as they go their separate ways. Both sides will be more confused than ever.
Indeed. Actually, there's probably one thing, Kyle will ask before he goes, like, oh, hey, so, just because I am wanting to make certain, the thing you had me build, what exactly was it for?
The frame and the weight. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. You mean the frame and the swivel?
Yeah.
You look at Chad, you look back, you'll laugh.
No, maybe. Go ahead.
It's theoretical, it might work. Kind of.
Okay, that it's
for laser tag. It's for laser tag. And this is the part where we need to make rolls.
Right. And I'm guessing you're rolling. I'm rolling.
Son of a bitch!
Oh my god.
Now I roll well with that.
So I'm guessing it came up more as it's for laser tag.
Yeah,
his face. Yeah, that was when I prepped laser tag.
Yeah. I'm gonna blame out of character, I'm gonna blame his sleep deprivation on the shit. It's the sleep deprivation.
Cal just goes, you're running a laser that's got enough power to actually develop recoil.
No, I just don't want it to break. Lasers are expensive. I'm not going to roll subterfuge because lasers off the market are expensive.
He's like,
Chad's going to put an arm around Kyle and go, look, when I build something, he really, really, really goes over the top that he won't have to build it again. It's a little quirk of his.
I understand over engineering something, but let's just say I stress tested it slightly and it broke my weights.
You gotta see his eyes light up, but he's just gonna smile and go, really?
And this is why I shouldn't give my.
Technically, it was a press, but No, don't worry.
This is why I shouldn't give my friend a rather large check to pimp us out for our for laser tag, and I like to roll. Okay. Manipulation subterfuge.
And I believe I'm still rolling perception and empathy.
Oh, what the fuck?
You are.
He sees through all of the technocracy deception.
Yeah!
You can't lie to a single human being.
There is the maybe I shouldn't have given him that much money. True.
Yeah.
Laser tag!
Maybe you shouldn't have said those last two words.
Yeah, it was totally those last two words.
Alright, now I want an empathy check.
Yeah.
I'm going to spend a point of willpower. Cameron, you need to oppose this. Unless you want to relent.
Yeah, this is pretty much something. Unless you manage to botch it somehow, no, you're not going to roll.
Okay. All right, I'm guaranteed one success. Oh, thank God, I have two successes.
Yeah, it's like I could take the dice for manipulation and subterfuge, which would be hilarious.
I just did empathy check to find out whether or not you believed the bullshit.
Oh God, no! Considering that I just botched, it's like, no, I don't believe you, and I am also fairly certain that you're hiding something else.
Kyle, could you give me Chad a second? Hey, he's gonna gesture for Chad to step into the next room.
Yeah, sure.
Is Chad gonna step into the next room with him?
Oh yeah.
All right, Cameron, do you want a perception test?
Which sort of perception would this be? Alertness or awareness?
Oh, just alertness. We're gonna be talking quietly in the next room. All
right. Oh well.
Okay.
Well, standard difficulty. That's two successes.
Yeah, he's probably going to overhear a little.
Yeah.
So, operator's going to pull Chad aside and go, he didn't buy any of that. Do you want to just tell him?
Let me write up a quick non-disclosure agreement.
Okay, yeah, that works, because it might help if we're not the only two guys looking out for things. And frankly, I want to tell him about Hoyt.
Yeah, no, he seemed okay, but I still wonder if he's fucking with us.
I don't.
I'm rolling intelligence.
Well, he's.
I'm doing this quickly without a bunch of other legal books, so I'm going to set the difficulty at 7 or 8. Which guys do you think?
Probably 8.
Well, it's okay. I'm going to have to shoot a lot. It's going to be 6.
Yeah, I forgot you had that.
Isn't that handy?
So even with the voluntarily increased penalties, yeah, I'm rocking out with 2 successes. And he's just, it's like after a few minutes, he'll come back out. Some of that's been quickly typed up, printed off. And he goes, okay, we're going to settle with you. Here's the NDA.
So... he's going to read the NDA.
Like really
I don't have law. Can I roll intelligence and investigation?
Yeah.
To see if there's anything that, you know, is very obviously going to screw me over. All right, and roll. Jesus. So is it just
pretty much... Dice stream is on this side tonight.
Yeah, it's pretty much, you know, that... the buyer values his privacy. You're not allowed to discuss what's been discussed there. You understand this. You're not allowed to tell slanderous lies about what was discussed as well. It says it's pretty much going specifically for slanderous lies. It doesn't give a shit if you tell other lies. And it's just going, but it's basically like, yeah, we'll sue the crap out of you if you start, you know, spreading shit around. And in return, you get this shiny dollar, which you will find paperclip to the back.
Right. So, you know, he looks over. It's like, oh, that's actually a fairly straightforward one. You know, signs it. Okay, what's up?
So, Operator 5 is going to reach into his pocket and hand you the scanning device.
And he just sort of looks at it and goes, so, what is this?
You register as a little weird. He's going to put his hand out for it back. So, yeah.
Compared to what?
Baseline
human?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
And what?
And not and I've what, got a what, weird.
Along what lines am I measuring it slightly off from baseline human?
I have no idea. I've never seen this before, man.
Because I've actually looked into a lot of the, you know, I'll be honest, I've looked into a lot of scanners. I've never seen one quite like that outside of science fiction novels.
Yeah. Okay. There's a couple things. Yeah, he's just going to gesture to the chair. You just sit down. All right. So, yeah, when I scanned you, you don't register the way the baseline does. Hoyt registers a lot like something else I've seen before. Avoid Hoyt.
Okay.
Best
if,
way
I mean,
I can...
If we're coming clean here, you guys also seem slightly off to me.
And Chad will just look at Operator 5 and go, radiation? It's probably radiation.
No, actually, specifically the earpieces.
That's when Operator 5 is going to look at Chad with that look of just, what the fuck?
I need to roll a manipulation subterfuge roll just to maintain the composure, because that is fucking weird.
with Operator 5, it's gone.
Six successes.
Congratulations, you managed to succeed on your first roll.
I just didn't do that well. So yeah, six successes. Well, that's unusual.
I built these things to hide from people like us. I mean,
That said, Hoyt seemed a lot weirder.
Hoyt's a Zerg. That's just what comes out of his mouth. He still has that look on his face. It's like, he doesn't even realize he said it.
Actually, no. Hoyt looks like... Okay, so about a month ago, I started seeing ghosts.
That's when he's going to look at Chad and go, we should have picked a different movie.
No. Seriously.
And then Thomas is going to look at Kyle and go, I am so sorry, we didn't know.
No. Okay, the movie's fine. I mean,
really?
I've been helping them pass on.
Chad will be walking off, he'll pick up a remote, and there'll be a little Wi-Fi in the corner, the speakers, you know, in different places, discreetly. Nice, calm, relaxing music. The same amount of, like, babbling book, just very inducing, a calm atmosphere, the lights are slightly dim, like, calm, nobody freak out kind of a thing going on.
But, the other night, I noticed three people who looked a bit odd. You up, you know, and that was the first time I'd seen you since this all happened. You had something sparkling around your head.
Yeah, he taps the earpiece. It functions as a mental shield.
Hoyt. He looked like he had someone superimposed on him. Or something.
Yeah, he... Right. It's not Chad's end of the business. He's been Earthside for most of his career.
Yeah, there's okay, you got shit on successes. You got shit on successes. We wouldn't just wince when you say Earthside.
Yeah.
Hoyt registers a lot like some of the guys I spent a lot of my early career running away from, screaming in terror. Demons is the best word for it. They're technically extra-dimensional entities, demons. They think they're demons. They work with worship.
If you take the concept that a demon can possess someone, that makes sense then.
Yeah, and I checked you for that before we let you into the car, too. There's nothing following you. There's nothing attached to you. You're fine.
Do you know 40K?
Yes.
They're warp xenos. I don't say demons, they're warp xenos.
Demons, whatever. But, no, like I said, and then also that Jericho guy, I noticed something about him as well, similar to you.
Yeah, he's with our opposing political faction, I guess you could call it. They think they're wizards.
Are they?
When you get to a certain point, you can't distinguish magic from science. They think they're doing magic. It's weird.
It's kind of sad, really.
Most of them are crazy. There's one particular group of them that tends to deal more with, like, technology and the internet. They're all right. I mean,
on plus side, that
guy, them, though.
We haven't found that guy sacrificing any chickens or babies, so, you know, we haven't had to deal with him.
Chickens, whatever, I'd draw the line there.
Yeah. There was that one time he called us at, like, 3 a.m., but...
Yeah, that was super nice of him.
He wanted to make sure we hadn't kidnapped anyone. It's weird.
Yeah, but he expressed that he wasn't investigating it. He just wanted to randomly make sure that we hadn't done it.
Right.
That's alright. If I saw somebody sacrificing a goat on the corner, I'd call him. Well, if he gave me a contact number. I'm still a little miffed about that. Whatever.
Honestly, if someone... whatever. I'll be honest. Up until I started seeing ghosts, the concept of magic didn't really have much appeal for me.
It's not really magic. Don't let them... It's a con game.
It quacks like a duck.
Yeah, there's multiple levels of the way the universe is set up.
I've
spent a lot of time. One of the weirder ones. Once you get out a certain distance, it all just kind of smushes into the same sandwich. That's a terrible analogy, but it's the best one I got at the moment. Sorry.
That's almost on the level of a Douglas Adams. They hung in the sky in exactly the same way that bricks don't.
Actually, he was kind of onto something, but yeah. Anyway. The thing that you're putting together.
Mm-hmm.
That's the frame for a particle cannon. Would you like another empathy test?
Sure.
Okay. I will relent.
At least I got one success, so it's only a failure.
Yeah, but I'm relenting to the challenge.
True, fair enough.
Yeah, you're pretty sure he's not crazy. It's not the truth. Yeah.
No, it's like, So, keep in mind, I have a PhD in a physical related science. Any particle I might know? Like, you know...
No. No, not really, not at all. It's
so you're not firing, say, gauge bosons at something?
Oh, no, you can't do that.
Which actually, those. Technically, if you're firing a laser at someone, I just realized.
Yeah, but no, you can't get the right amount of... basically, think of it as the glue that holds everything together. You know that unknown force that's not on the periodic table because we can't figure out how it works? Well, some of us have figured out how it works.
Wait, unknown force. Yeah. That's the thing.
It's kind
periodic table's pretty well taken care of. Supersymmetry, we
simply... There's a couple things that aren't on there yet, because it'll be a few more decades. But that particular stuff, the glue that holds reality together, I'm going to be shooting that at horrible monsters.
It's not for you, aliens, don't worry.
So it's basically it's basically a GUT gun. Grand Unified Theory?
Yeah, that's a good way of looking at it.
Okay.
That's just really tiring to use.
Now, hopefully with that mount it will be less tiring.
No, because you gotta power it somehow.
So
yeah, I can kind of tap that power a little, but it's just, it wears you out. I gotta build batteries.
So to go along the 40K analogy, you guys are kind of like psychers firing warp weapons?
Thomas is just gonna look at Chad. Because he doesn't know 40K.
No. We're the Adeptus Mechanicus, and we're shooting them with super science.
Yeah, but you're powering the super science with yourselves.
Sure!
Give me an analogy, Chad. Give me an analogy, Chad.
We're using up our internal energy, like mana in WoW or something.
Okay.
Okay,
let's be honest. 40K is not going to be a 1-to-1 here, but, you know.
Mechanicus.
Best way to put it is that stuff where it glues everything together, the universal force.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of conduiter.
Okay.
Yeah. If you're of a particular enlightenment, you can retain it for a while, or retain a little bit more, or you can channel a bit more of it. That's about the best way I can describe it at the moment.
Is not something we're going to be using on normal people. The kind of things we're looking at are things like Hoyt, who are, you know, have taken over some normal guy and are up to, well,
I mean,
horrible ends.
Well, okay, you guys are saying he beats his demon. Fair enough. Or
there's there's a different level of things on the badness scale.
The question,
he's gonna air quotes as he says, demons are pretty high up there.
Well, and to be perfectly honest, there's one of the few quotes from the Bible that I still enjoy is, "You know a spirit by its fruits." Okay, yes, he's obviously somehow possessing this guy, but might there be extenuating circumstances?
We gotta find out whether or not he's just riding a body, or whether or not there's still somebody in there.
Yeah, it's a good question, whether or not there's someone in there.
Because I've pulled a couple entities out of people before. It's just, I haven't had time to put anything together for that, because he's just going to stop pretending not to be exhausted. Ever since the attack last month, I've been working on things.
The terrorist attack.
Yeah, they were monsters. I'm not sure what kind. They weren't aliens. I know that much. But.
I know at least one of them had some sort of darkness power. At least one of them had some
sort
of darkness
power.
And they were opposed by some other sort of critter.
Yeah, I didn't get any footage from that bit of the scuffle.
Just say I came into some of my own. I no longer have it for security reasons. But essentially, someone went up there to try and talk them down, and they just killed him.
Yeah, I got that part of the footage.
And then some sort of thing that looked like kind of looked like if he took the Egyptian god Anubis and put him in a giant 9-foot tall body, and he just started ripping tearing their shit apart.
Thomas is going to look at Chad and go, "Yeah, we find out who that is. I'm going to get him a fruit basket."
You think you could get us a copy of that footage again?
Let's just say the person who offered it to me was even more paranoid than I am about security. Okay. So probably not.
I gave Jericho a copy of the footage I have. The guy that went riding off in his bike in terror the other night. Yeah. Just told him what point was. You remember the guy that was driving the ice cream truck that night?
Mm-hmm.
He's with me. He's one of my guys. His name is Tony. If something horrible goes down, he'll pop up and give you the heads up.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate that.
Yeah. Okay. So, did you and Matt talk at all the other night?
Yeah, a little.
Okay. He's all right from what I can tell so far.
Oh, Matt is? Yeah, Matt's fine.
Yeah. Okay. Because Jericho introduced us that night, and he seemed fairly on the ball, and I wanted to get the hell out of there.
Yeah. You did... You used a word that you told him, and he actually told me later. It was what? It was Latin for unhallowed one.
Nephandi.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so... Hold on. All right, so... you were in the know before this, and you talked with Matt about... Okay, well, that narrows things down considerably. Alright. We have the network. We're going to look at Chad. We're going to have to network. We can't do this on our own. We're going to have to network.
Yeah. If you can convince whoever it is got you that info, leave us a copy or even get a viewing. We have some information they might not have as well if they're willing to exchange. And he just kind of looks at Operator 5. Found out a few things. Not necessary as it seemed, Lammy, but all the boys in blues have turned up with something, at least.
The ice cream shop. I've got a laboratory underneath it. If you ever need to hide out someplace.
Okay. I've got a few places of my own to hide out at, but I appreciate the offer.
Yeah, I haven't quite gotten the automated systems up yet. It's gonna be busy. Building energy disruptors.
Let's just say my aunt surprised me by including me in her will.
That's always pleasant. Yeah. Good. Look at Chad. He's gonna look at Kyle again. Wanna make this a thing? Like movie night once a week?
Sure. Movie night and
talk shop and whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, that sounds very workable.
Okay. This is gonna sound like a weird question. Do you know how to use a gun?
No. I'm not quite a pacifist.
You wanna fix that?
Learned how to fight.
Okay, if you want to learn how to shoot something, just let me know.
If that comes up,
I'm a fairly decent teacher. Yeah. The young kid says he's a fairly decent teacher.
The young kid who's building particle guns.
If... before I was being nice about it, but seriously, no, I'm... pretty good when I have more time to actually work stuff out. If you need a, if you're coming with anything, tighten stuff up on the legal side. I say you've been vetted a bit now at this stage, so.
Right.
Something. But yeah, no, even when, I've told me before what you've been up to. Yeah, I know, make her seem like a decent lot. They're the kind of people we like to support, as science is good. Super science is better, but science is good. We want more people to just, you know, there's some other things to do, or it was like, to steal from the army, we want people to be all they can be. You know, we don't like the bullshit that a lot of, well, we've had to deal with some nasty stuff. I'm not even going to go into it.
Kentucky just rubs his forehead.
Well, I'll be honest. Growing up, I read a lot of science fiction, including stuff like a lot of Vryn's and Niven's novels. Once I got past like the classics such as Foundation, and
they were under a few things.
Yeah, actually been following David Brin's blog, and largely, I disagree with him on a few particulars, but you know, everyone's going to do that. But I like a lot of his ideas, especially, and one of Niven's points that he made, I was like, look, if you have a disability, you are for technology. There is no other option. And there's certain things that even though, okay, humanity's gone without them for ages, there's still disabilities, such as, hey, I can't see in the ultraviolet or the infrared. I can't see radio waves. Okay, technically I couldn't resolve radio waves inside my eye, but that's beside the point.
Yeah, you don't want to look at everything out there. That's how you go crazy.
Yeah.
And you see this, like, shadow pass over Operator 5. Like, he's seen it before.
But that's technology is essentially tools to overcome those disabilities that we didn't realize we had.
Yeah, to put it bluntly, like I said, well, as Op was saying, you know, someone's a child of things, but to put it bluntly, Op's, he's a prodigy. I just smack people with legalese and bureaucracy when they get out of line. I am not going to be running out with a noisy cricket and shooting at people. That's not me.
Right, right.
But Op is, yeah, he'll tap the thing. He's like, this, I can get the basics. This is kind of, what he can do in a week would take me at least a year to do.
Well then, I wouldn't necessarily, not to toot my horn too much, but I was, sole reason I came second in my class, classes in undergrad in my department is because I caught the pneumonia. Caught pneumonia at one point.
Oh, no, no.
That took me out for pretty much finals week.
Oh, don't worry. When it comes to, like, stuff that's on the market or almost on the market, from what I've heard, you'd definitely outstrip me. I've focused in other areas. So much red tape, it hurts them.
Hmm. No, I mean, you know...
Yeah, it's kind of fun to watch.
No, but, so, I'm not necessarily a prodigy, but I've been called a genius before by people with many more letters after the name than I do have. And I am selling, you know, filtration systems to people that represent the royal family of Dubai. I'm kind of doing both of myself.
Yeah, that kind of reminds me. If I ever have free time, and if the city stops, you know, being attacked by horrible monsters on a regular basis, I was going to ask you to help me work on a filtration project.
What are you needing to filter?
The river.
Oh, is that all?
Yeah, it's one of those things. Of course, my entire timetable's been put back almost a year.
Of course, what you really want to do as far as that filtration goes, and some of it you just have to dredge up the river and get rid of a certain amount of muck. A lot of it, though, you'd have to find the polluting industries upriver and stick the filtration over there for the highest effect.
Trust me, man, if the river, the other stuff, if we didn't have things causing so much trouble you to clean up the messes of, you'd be an officer in Starfleet by now. But no. It's got to be Dick.
Right. All these little monsters. Well,
there's just so much to do.
Alright, well then, this has been a very interesting conversation, and I didn't expect, you know, when you got the NDA, I expected you to go, yeah, I'm building a weapon. Not this.
A little bit of yes, a little bit no. Yeah, we're building a weapon. We're not building it for profits.
Now, that
reminds me, I got to finish decommissioning the pistols.
Well, the way I see it is, like, I can, at times, see unusual things. I usually prefer to, because the first thing I ever saw was a ghost that was sobbing because his family was doing poorly ever since he died. So what I did was I went and took care of his family, and as far as I can tell, the ghost moved on.
Man, so, if you see something. Okay, if you see something and it's too big for you, call. If you see something and it's trying to eat you,
well, run.
Go to the ice cream shop. Yeah, go to the ice cream shop.
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, because things have a harder time getting there. You know how people have trouble remembering me?
Yeah. Yeah, it took me a while.
The ice cream. Yeah, that's because I was trying to make sure you could remember me. I've kind of managed to duplicate the effect a little on the ice cream shop.
Not bad.
Yeah. Someday I'll figure out how it all works. But yeah.
But, you know, I've got your number, so I mean, at the very least, I can put you on my one of my emergency speed dials.
Yeah.
That way, if I do run into something that's trying to eat me, and it's then I'll have another option.
And actually, besides that particular cell phone number you've got, he's gonna hand you a card that's actually got the ice cream shop number on it. When the answering machine picks up, and it does automatically, just ask for operator 5, and it'll punch you through to me.
Chad's just hot. I hand him a business. It's got a mobile number and an office number. It's a nice-looking card, but, you know, he's now asking you to punch through to different people and things.
Because the ice cream shop has a secure line, so...
I assume that, well, the NDA covers anything that's technically proprietary to your organization. I can pass along certain other details.
Like what?
Such as, you know, anything, any of these creatures that aren't a part of your organization that you have any details on.
Oh, you want to talk about it? Yeah, if you want to pass on details about the demons and that kind of thing, yeah, I suppose if you think other people need to be warned. To put it bluntly, yeah, whether you signed that or not, if you went off and started spouting off at the rooftops.
Oh, no, I'm not gonna like stick this on a conspiracy site or anything.
It wouldn't be getting happening. You'd be, you know, having a nice vacation. And, you know, we'd have a chat with you. Not in a sinister way, but just kind of a, yeah, no, you can't be doing that. And it would take a lot of effort to cover the media stuff. It's just...
No. I understand the whole concept of don't tell people things they're not ready for.
Yeah, we tend to operate in the black a lot.
Let's just say I've run into one other guy, well, at least one other guy, but... This one guy I ran into could also see things like me. He was certain that it was he just had bad acid at one point, and these were just flashbacks. Kind of avoids me because I kind of break that concept for him.
Yeah, a lot of people just aren't ready for it. Well, most people just aren't ready for it, to be honest.
Well, and yeah.
Do you have any kind of explanation as to what's going on, or just one day you start seeing this stuff?
Like I said, I'm not the only one. I've heard one or two explanations. They don't make a lot of sense.
Okay, well, society's always had people talking about...
Let me put it this way. The one of these that makes the most sense is that we've been chosen by God.
Okay, so societies, well, the cultures of all over the world have had oracles and mediums, which, of course, most of them could be hoax, bunk. Some of them might just be noticing weird shit and somehow tapping in a bit more. So maybe that's what's going on with you.
Yeah.
Possibly.
We'll have to swap horror stories at some point. I mean, if you see anything like a giant naked roll map, or
mole rat running through the streets call us. So we've dealt with that kind of thing before. He just kind of starts brushing stuff off of his arms, you know, like there's something there. Yeah, I, you know, when that fucking scene in Ghostbusters made him cringe.
Yeah, that's the thing. If something's messing with a person and they're acting really weird, the cops just shoot them. People get a lot more finicky when it comes to animals for some reason, especially when it's in an urban area. Countryside, oh look, the dog seems to have rabies. Shotgun round, problem solved.
Yeah.
In the city, everyone gets a bit worked up and they're calling animal control and it's just a mess.
Yeah.
Not to alarm you or anything, but yeah, be careful who you talk to about this stuff, because besides us, there's other groups out there, and they're just out for whatever ends.
Let me put it this way. About the only sort of people I'd be likely to share this with are a handful of others I've met that are like me.
Yeah. And I haven't finished the scanners yet, but I'm trying to set up a network so that I can pick things up if they happen. Do you mind if I put one on your roof?
Sure.
That size of a fuse box. And, you know, if the aliens land on your doorstep, it'll give you a heads up.
Honestly, if they're going to be coming after any place of mine, it's most likely going to be the makerspace. And while we don't have anything that's actually designed to be a weapon, we pretty much try and avoid making things that are weapons. It's amazing what you can improvise with.
I've had some experience with that.
I just take the presses, for instance.
Unfortunately, what do they call on the internet? If the grays show up, your presses aren't going to help.
Well.
Those guys in particular, I don't want to keep an eye on them.
Well,
they don't like me anymore. Well, they've never liked me, but they seem to have an issue with me more now. So.
Well, one thing I do know is that I do have a measure of protection.
That's good.
Largely, it tends to look like luck, but it goes well beyond any reasonable level of luck.
He's going to kind of shoot Chad on luck at that point. Okay. I've kind of heard people like us that have that knack before.
Well, let's just say that once when there was an accidental fire, I managed to escape out a window.
Ah, that works.
By accidental, I mean, to the best of my knowledge, accidental.
Yeah, by accidental,
I pretty much fell out of it. Managed to avoid hitting any of the glass on the way down and landed on a bunch of mattresses that had been tossed out on the side.
He's going to pull out the track recorder. Let's just call it what it is. And he's gonna scan.
Oh no. This is gonna make you even more confused, because it's doubtful you get the nice successes again.
I'm gonna spend another point of willpower.
You're burning your willpower, you madman.
Yeah, it's a good thing I spent it too. So that's 7, a 6, and a 10.
So he's not, he's come up as a completely normal human now.
He's gonna look at the track order. And he's gonna shake his head.
What is it? Let me see.
He's gonna show chat. He's gonna point at, you know, 2 or 3 particular readouts.
Do it again. He's just looking at it. Do it again.
He's gonna reset the device. Actually, he's gonna power it down. Count to 13 and power it back on, and then scan you again.
Still come up as a completely normal human. So it's kind of like,
yeah.
What?
So
hold on. And
so
he's gonna pull out his Omni Jewel. He's gonna press it against the thing. It's gonna make a whirring sound. And then he's gonna scan you again. Like, yeah.
So what you're saying is, so I'm guessing based on the fact that you noticed me once and not recently, I'm a transient anomaly?
At this stage, Chad's going to go over, he's going to take out a Ziploc plastic bag, and he's going to take like some of your pizza crust and you have a bit of saliva, and he just puts it in, he looks at you, and he zips it closed, and he goes, fuck it, we're doing a DNA test.
Cool. No, hey, if you find anything that can explain this, that would be interesting.
Sure. No, it's your DNA. It's like, what the fuck?
No, Kyle just says, he's like, if you can find anything that can explain
this. Yeah, I know, he's just like, what this?
Yeah, like I said, there have been a lot of different explanations, and none of them made really any sense.
Chad's going to pull Operator 5 a little closer. Have you ever seen him do that before?
He's going to kind of look up at Kyle and go, I'm going to build a scan. Like a giant MRI. We're gonna find the box. He's actually gonna flip the thing open with the multi-tool. He's going to pull the back panel off. He's gonna pull out a box, which, yeah, it's power supply. He's gonna press the multi-tool against it, reset it, gonna put it back in, gonna seal the back of the device again, and it's sealed, like the seam disappears. And then he's going to scan you again. Yeah, I'm building an MRI. Something like that, yeah.
Were you
just gotta listen to Chad and Chris.
Exerting yourself in any way when okay, we drove by in a van that pulled up, and we scanned you, and you were showing up weird, but now that you're here...
That was the black van?
Yeah, we wanted to make sure you weren't being corrupted by the
No, fair enough, I'm just...
I'm not going to bring you back to my house if you've got a demon
in. No, I fully understand. I just... In a van with black tinted windows, that's kind of playing the stereotype.
Operator 5 is going to look at me and go, it's all I can afford.
Okay.
Like, just deadpan, completely deadpan. He doesn't understand what you're talking about.
At least it's not a Cadillac.
Oh, God. Even used Cadillacs, those things are expensive. They have terrible roll cages. He just goes back to... Yeah, it's like... I don't know.
So at this stage, Chaz is going to put his arm around Kyle and go, okay, I've rung a taxi, it's down below. Well, it's been a confusing evening, and we've come off, well, we're making progress, but coming up with far more questions than answers. You seem to be just irregular, but very pleasant. Thank you for coming over. I look forward to seeing you again.
Oh, yeah, and, you know, I'll see if I can get anything that I might be able to share with you.
I'll swing by in a couple days. Call if you need help, or swing by the ice cream shop. And he's just kind of fiddling with the machine, because he is so confused.
Yeah. And, you know, Kyle heads on down and says, turns back and says, so, for next time, since you're now fairly certain I'm not infested, I guess I can drive on over here?
Sure.
All right. You guys might like my motorcycle.
And once the doors close, he looks at Operator 5. He just mouths, what the fuck? And he goes over. You were...
Are
you serious about this?
Yeah, he's good people. I mean, stress testing our particle cannon, right? We're going to need help, man. Get barely anything, and he's not a horrible monster. Nope. Great, now what's up?
Maybe he pressed the wrong button, although he says he sees things, so... I don't know.
Yeah, I reset it.
Maybe you made a mistake the first time. Maybe you made a mistake the first time. You've been really tired lately.
He's just gonna look up at you. Yeah, he's just gonna look up at you and go, that would be feasible.
You know, you've been tired a lot. He's willing to go down and sit down for more scans and stuff. It's probably, maybe he's. To put up really some maybe kind of low psychic or something.
Maybe there's some kind of residual effect lingering him through an anomaly. There was that one time at Saturn.
Don't worry about Saturn. Let's focus on here now. And he takes out a key and then he goes over to safe. Hidden like a little wall safe, and then he takes out some paperwork, which he would put there in the evening for when they arrived. So, let me tell you about a little place called Suster, and I think we can end the scene there.